Hi, everybody, and thanks again. Welcome to another Medic Monday quick tip where we answer a couple Q&As from people that have sent in. The question today was, hey, I'm getting ready to eat a bunch with my family and have a great meal. How do I tell the difference between heartburn and a heart attack? Now, one of those, not so much a big deal. One of those, kind of a critical issue. So let's go over it. It's a little bit more benign to start with and then a little bit more easy to define towards the end. So what do we think of when we think of heartburn? Well, most of us think of that indigestion. They generally feel what we call substernum. So your sternum, sub underneath. So just underneath your sternum, kind of right where your esophagus. See, right about right here is where your esophagus finally gets to dump out into your stomach. So a lot of times, this is generally the sensation of heartburn and indigestion that we feel, right? You don't necessarily feel the acid stomach. That's kind of a different sensation. This is that, man, I feel like in my swallowing pipe, my esophagus, it's just raw, it burns, it's got heat. And generally, this is that section, okay? There's a lot of parts of the esophagus and as the stomach comes up, okay? But that's generally where we would feel it, right? That we most feel it in the throat to about there. Well, that's also, unfortunately, right about where a lot of people sense their first sensation of chest pain that's cardiac related. So how do we really know the difference? Let me throw out a couple that are so profound that they need to catch your attention right away. Don't push these back. Don't try to convince yourself that these aren't a big deal. If you have some of these following signs and symptoms, it's a big deal. If you're having that substernal or chest pain that's right there, and it doesn't go away. You drank some water, you moved around just to make sure it's not your muscles cramping up and anything like that. You moved around, and I'm talking like minutes, right? And it's staying there. Evaluate it. Call it a 0 if it's nothing, a 1 if it's a little pain, 10 out of 10 if it's the worst pain ever, and evaluate it and see if it starts going anywhere. Does it stay? If it's just a 0, 1, or 2, and it just stays there the whole time, it could be heartburn, right? But if it stays 1 or 2 and it starts escalating up in your pain scale, you need to take that seriously. You need to take any sensation that it's moved, we call that radiate, but that it's radiated or moved at all, that is a huge issue. That is not gonna be something you're gonna experience in general with heartburn or indigestion. So if your chest discomfort or indigestion starts here, and that starts coming up into your chest, specifically on your left side, like over your heart, that's a big deal. You need to take this seriously. If you start having a tightness, a locking up, a pain sensation that goes up on your neck, either side, or into your jaw, either side, that is a really concerning sign that we need you to take serious. If you're having pain and disability going down into your arm, shooting, stabbing, electric, whatever you want to call it, that is another really clinical sign that, listen, this might be a lot more than indigestion and you need to take it seriously. That being said, how do you take it serious? Do you know what I mean? Like what do you really do for if you think you're starting to have a heart attack or you think that could be what you're experiencing? First and foremost, trust yourself. Trust yourself. If you think you're really having something that's more than indigestion, do not come up with the reasons why it's not what it is. If you really thought it was bad enough to call 911, call 911. Here's the other thing. We're happy to show up. Even if it's nothing at all, we're happy to show up. We're happy to run that EKG, run that 12 lead on you, take some labs for you if that's what you need. We're happy to assist you, even if it turns out that 20 minutes later, everything abates on its own and it was just indigestion. There's no harm, no foul. Please call us if you're really having that type of chest pain. Second is don't wait. Don't wait. Don't wait for hours and hours and hours until the food is gone and the party is over and any of that before you finally take yourself serious. Trust yourself. If you're having chest pain that is radiating to your arm, radiating to your neck, radiating to your jaw, moving around in your chest and not just staying isolated into kind of what they call that substernal region, then you could potentially be having a heart attack. So join us next time and we'll get into the difference of what a heart attack and cardiac arrest actually are and how they are not the same. And you've got a lot of time with the heart attack, so take that serious, okay? Join us next time for another Q&A where we talk about heart attack and cardiac arrest.